Hey guys, I'm in my living room here tonight, and I'm trying out my new camera. I know I've been talking to some people on my channel about the fact that I need a new camera for a while, and I decided to break down and go out and get one tonight. Here in my living room, you know, it's after dark, so I've just got the lights on, and the lighting's terrible. Now, my last camera, it would go and kind of go in and out of focus when I tried to do a video in here. And it was just lousy, so I'm going to see how this one does, and then if it does okay in here, I know it's going to do great when I get it out, you know, filming cars and that kind of stuff. But while we got it out, I thought we'd do, you know, some sort of video here, so I'm kind of learning how to use this here yet, but the one I picked up, just to show you here real quick since I'm holding it, is the Sony Handycam. And this is an HDR-CX110. And I really wanted the CX550. It would have been my first choice, or maybe a CX350. But those are very expensive. I mean, you're talking, I don't know, $1,000 camera. And I just couldn't justify that right now because I just got this channel started. And when I started it, I kind of told myself that it's going to have to pay for itself as it goes along. So as I make more money, actually off of YouTube, then... you know, I'll start increasing, you know, the amount, you know, start improving my equipment, buying better software, trying to make better videos, that kind of stuff as I go along. So, and hopefully people will kind of bear with me along the way as things get better. So, oh, for anybody that's curious, this is the camera that I've been using all this time. It's a Sony CyberShot W370. And as you can see, this is really just a still camera for the most part. And I bought this to take pictures of my guitars and my artwork when I was selling them all the time. And it works great for that. It's 14.1 megapixel, and it's a great camera for that. Now, it does have 720 HD video, and that's why I started making the YouTube videos with it. And, you know, what can I say? I mean, it helped me build my channel and get started, but it's really not a video camera to speak of. So I knew I had to... you know, upgrade a little bit. But since I'm out in here, I thought, you know, I drug out a few of my guitars and I was kind of figuring out which one I wanted to play. But this is my Delta Darling guitar. You can see with the Bomber Girl art and everything. You know, if you guys, I've got videos of all this if you guys want to go look at it. But there's my, it says Trample the Weak and Hurl the Dead, my kind of rock and roll guitar. And that's got a Fender single coil in it. This one, I don't know if you guys have seen this one in a video yet, but... this particular guitar is signed by Larry the Cable Guy, and this is Jeff Get Her Done, Dude I Love My Cigar Box Axe, because I had presented Larry with his cigar box guitar that day, so he signed mine, and now this hangs on my living room wall, and I'll never sell it or anything, because that's kind of a little, you know, memento. And then I've got my little Arturo Fuente cigar box guitar here. This is actually one of my favorites to play around on. And for those of you that don't know, these are completely handmade. There's kitchen cabinet hinges, there's trunk hinges, brass, you know, light switch plates. The frets are made out of windshield wiper blades that I cut and rounded and leveled and everything. And the entire neck, this is all just built from scrap wood that I laminated together and shaped and everything. And it's a true cigar box, so it's even got a bolt up here, you know, for the nut and everything like that, and little eyelets for string retainers. I mean, it's just completely homemade. And anyway, I'm going to crank that one up here a little bit and see how it goes. I'm still getting used to this flip screen thing. But anyway, I'm going to put this on the tripod and I'm going to play a little bit because I want to see if this thing can handle the audio. And so bear with me just for a second while I put you guys on here, because as of right now, I'm still not, I still haven't edited one single video the whole time, but that's going to change here shortly too. I'm going to start editing my videos and make them a little nicer, but anyway, I've gotten on the tripod, and we're going to see if this thing can handle the sound. If you guys, you know, if you've seen me play before, you know that I'm a terrible slide guitar player. But I'm going to give it a shot just to see how the volume is and if it's going to be able to handle this. And I'm just playing through my the little junk karaoke machine tonight. But it'd be good enough to test the volume and see how it goes and everything. And you'll notice this thing, I've got the volume cranked all the way, and you hear no hum or anything out of that. And that's because, I mean, everything is, you know, properly grounded and set up to where you don't get all that buzz out of your strings and everything. And when I deaden them, they go completely dead. So anyway, I'm going to try a little bit and we'll just see if it can handle the sound. But at least we could try it out and see if it blares the speaker out or whatever, you know. But it'd be a good test. So anyway, thanks for hanging in there with me through all these months with the junk camera there. And hopefully this camera is going to make a big difference in like my car videos and that kind of thing. That's really what I'm worried about more so. And but we'll see if it works in this terrible lighting here first. But thanks for watching, commenting, and rating and everything like that. I really do appreciate it. And I'll see you later. Bye.